Hello, thanks for joining me today on the Monochromatic Pour. So today I wanted to pick a summery color because as you can see, it's dwindling. It's cooler. It's nice. I like it. It's just different. Leading into fall. So I decided to go with orange because it's a summery color. So we'll be adding different shades and tints of orange into one pour. So I'll show you what I got. I have this weird color called spiced carrot, so I wanted to start with that as a base, and then I added yellow and red to make some more because I ran out. So as you can see, there's some glue that hasn't been mixed in yet. That's because I'm going to be mixing it a little bit more. So I'll be adding some black and some white to these. First one, we'll just add a little bit of black. The next one, we'll add a lot of bit of black. These will be the shades. And then I want a regular orange. And then white, we'll make a few tints. So again, ones with a lot of white. And a little white. And we gotta add some water too. Just kind of eyeball it. Mix until you have the consistency you want, which I'm shooting for the same on all of them, so we'll see how it goes. Beautiful color here. Here's just the regular orange. This should pour really easily. It's kind of runny. I might have to add more paint to it. We'll see. This one's got a little white on it, so it's a little lighter. It's pretty peachy. know, teeny runny, so I think I'm going to add a little bit more yellow and red. Line up here, we got dark to light. So then I'll just go down the line here. So you can see the layers we got going on. We're gonna pour on this picture frame. I was waiting on some canvases, they didn't ship yet, so figured this will do for now. And I propped it up with this little organizer. So I'm just gonna cover it in black and then we're gonna pour on it. Thank you. This has been sitting a little bit. See the layers. It's definitely challenging pouring over something you're not used to. Otherwise, there's some cool swirls going on, some things that are emerging. We have some fun cleaning these up. So I might just wait for those to dry and probably scrape some paint off. So we'll come back in a couple days and check it out. Check it out. Some of the black base coat mixed in with the orange, so it created some fun colors. So if you look really closely, like you can see some of these little chunks in here. So a good tip if you're using some older paint, you can use one of those strainers. And I think they're on Amazon, but they're just like paint strainers. I'll find a link for you and put in the description. I think that's probably a huge thing that would have helped here, but since this is for personal use, I don't think it's a really big deal. You can get an overall look here. Then I'll be doing the back here. A little bit went over, but not much. I ended up scraping the sides because they were a little too thick. So you can see with the monochromatic pour, it gives more of a subtle look if that's something you're looking for with your acrylic pour versus something more kind of contrasting and vibrant, you can do something like this. So by adding shades and tints, you can create just something that's more kind of lighter in contrast and isn't so in your face. So hope you guys enjoyed it. If you liked it, let me know. And if you'd like to see more like this, let me know, drop a comment, hit subscribe if you like this video and like to see more. Next week I will be taking a break for Labor Day. So on holiday weeks I'm taking breaks because life is disease. So hope you guys liked it. Have a great holiday week and I'll see you in 2 weeks. Bye.